Amazon Music.
What's up, everybody out there in YouTube world? Are we going to be fist pumping today or what? Today's going to be a good day. Went to Easter dinner yesterday, and my nephew was there. He says, I watched The Breakfast Club the other day, and my dad said that that's basically how you dressed in high school. Listen, I went to high school from 81 to 85. That movie came out in 85, but I was dressing like that prior, all right? Just so you all know. I told you I'm a chameleon. I have a bunch of many things. I told you about sports, Rambo-y, you know, Breakfast Club, Judd Nelson. This shit is still in style, all right? Denim coats, flannel shirts, some Dickies, some bandanas. He carried a switchblade. I'm carrying a boot knife. Okay? I don't know if you can see that. Anyway.
Just sometimes. But the reason why we're here is we're going to talk about my movie collection knives. All right, it took me a long time to get these. I'm still waiting on a few more. By the time they come, God only knows. But I'm going to show you what I got so far. So I'm going to be picking you up and taking you on a trip. And I think we should start with... my Rambo. Got to start with Rambo. And The Expendables. You guys have seen it before if you've paid attention, but I have to include them. So give me one second here. Alexa, pause. All right, that's enough of that. A little excited here. Expendables. All right. There we go. It's always nice breaking out these beauties. Expendables 1. Look at that Hibben Bowie. Beauty, right? Hibben 2. The toothpick. I mean Hibben 2. Expendables 2. The toothpick. And this one, I believe, was in Expendables 2 as well. 1 and 2. And you know what? Here's the throwing knives. By the Hibben Expendables crew. And what should I say, Frost Cutlery? All right. Yeah, something like that. Do I have that box? I got the box, Andy. Where are you? All right. Okay, sorry about that. Then there's that killer Legionnaire. All right. Such a beautiful knife. Also by Hibben. Now these last two here, I had questioned about this one. This is called the AXD 3D Tanto. And I do believe it is just a Darryl Ralph, ripoff. His was a pocket knife, runs about $12 to $2,000. This is full tang. It has the, expendable Skull and Raven on it. The sheath isn't really that great, but this thing is solid, it's sharp, and just badass. And of course, last but not least, from the Expendables 1, Mickey Rourke's the Espada, his character had carried that. Look at that beast. To do a comparison on this cold steel Espada, let's see, how big the Bowie was in the first one. So to give you an idea of its size, look at that. Compared to the toothpick, compared to the throwing knives, and compared to the Legionnaire. All right, so there it is once again, ladies and gentlemen, my Expendables. And then, of course, what started it all, my Rambo knife collection. I got all four These are, I believe, the best you can actually get. They're signature editions. Let's see. Hollywood Collectible. I had a good workout today, if I'm breathing heavy again. I'm always trying to get situated. All right. But it's going to rain, so I'm trying to do this a little quick. And there's that Beast Rambo 3. And then Rambo 4. That Mighty Machete. And that is, that wrap is some sort of a goat skin. And I'm leaving one spot open. There's my Rambo 5 t-shirt. God, I can't wait to get my hands on that. They better mass produce it. If not, I'm gonna be paying like $5,000-$10,000 for it. I believe it's being, the knife itself is being made by a guy named Pohl, P-O-H-L. And yeah, his blades are pretty damn expensive. So anyway, Rambo Expendables once again. Now, there's some knives over here in my movie collection. Some, you're gonna say, nah, that wasn't in the movie. Some, you're gonna go, hey, I have that knife. I had no idea that was in a movie. So, and if there's any that I'm missing, let me know. I'd like to get my hands on it, all right? So let's start off with my first, my bug out bag. Now, from Full Metal Jacket, Animal Mother, if you look close to his what do you call it, a rucksack? I was in the Navy, so I'm not too sure. But anyway, he carried that Ontario machete. And that's where my guy sits. Oop, give me a second. I'm gonna get him out for you, but I got one hand here. Do I really need to take this out? There we go. There she is. And I do use this machete. Made in the USA. Can't beat that with a stick. And on the other side, if you ever see Lone Survivor, you're going to see that Marcus Luttrell, played by Mark Wahlberg, he carries the SOG seal pup. So, case of a zombie apocalypse, or just riding the subway in Philly, and I gotta get, this is my quick bag. Got my water bottle, binoculars, a fire starter, because you know, I might need to start a fire somewhere in the city. But you guys get it. All right, you're knife enthusiasts, you know what I'm trying to say. All right, so that's that. Okay, here we go. Movie called Shot Caller. I don't know if you guys ever seen it. This is a kick-ass movie. It's only like maybe a year or two old. It's a badass movie. Highly recommend it. Let's see. At one point in the movie, he goes to the hardware store. And they show it really quick, and he bought two knives. And I had to quick freeze frame it to get the name brand of the knife. So these were the knives that he used in Shot Caller. There we go. That's the package. You could probably, you know, pause it real quick if you've seen the movie. He takes two of these, and he duct tapes them to his hands and his wrists, and yeah, he goes to town on somebody. But yeah, these little guys are like $5 each, $6 each. Sharp. Highly recommend. I purchased these at Harbor Freight. All right, let's go for another. I just picked this one movie out because it's my favorite Nicolas Cage movie. And he uses the Buck 110 and a brown sheath. I have a black and a brown. The Buck 110, movie's called Joe. It's one of Cage's most recent flicks, and I think it may be one of his best, if not the best. And I love how he carries around his Buck 110. He really really knew how to cut a deer up, making those butterfly steaks. And one of my favorite scenes is when he's trying to carve a, you know, gouge a bullet out of his shoulder using his Buck 110. All right, let's move on. Sin City. Sin City. You're like, what knife was from there? Well, Mickey Rourke's character, he goes to hunt down one of the villains, and he used the East Wing hatchet, which I use all the time. One of the best hatchets on the planet. And if you didn't know it was in Sin City, well, it really is. Although the one in the movie has like a little, like a cutout, like right about there. So yes, the East Wing, the hatchet. I didn't ever really own that many hatchets in my life, but I won't own another. This thing is, you know, this thing is the shit. Okay, moving on. The original Alamo. The Alamo. I got this bad boy a few years back. Oh, ting. There's my Alamo knife. Beauty, huh? And it's a master cutlery piece. If you can see that. Okay, it's got the guard on it. Jim Bowie, he's our man. If he can't do it, nobody can. Okay, let's move on to Scream. Come on, everybody's gotta have this knife. The Buck 119 was used in all the Screams. 1, 2, 3, 4. Made in the USA. And I do believe they sell them in rubber too, for those of you out there that aren't allowed to, you know, own a knife yet. Get the rubber one. You know, it works great with the Ghostface costume. All right, now here's one that's going to throw y'all for a loop. The season of Fargo. Season 2. There was one of my favorite characters, the Indian named Hansi. He carried the Buck 124. Yeah, this is my second favorite buck of all time. My first is the 110, and then he got the 124. So in case y'all were ever wondering what kind of knife Hansi was carrying, it's the Buck 124. All right, I really like this sheath. Really like that sheath. Okay, now we were talking about Full Metal Jacket earlier. This knife was used in a few films. Once again, it's in a lot of war movies, but most recently, if you're fans of Sons of Anarchy, the main character carries the K-bar right there, the USMC, the 7-inch, not the non-serrated. Correct me if I'm wrong, people. And I did get this sheath is my USMC, but I do have a plain leather K-bar sheath as well. Because I don't think that his said USMC on his, to be more movie accurate, you know what I mean? So, that is, from Sons of Anarchy. The K-bar, 7-inch blade, and non-serrated. All right, you guys waiting for this next one? I've had this knife for quite some time and just realized that it's actually used in Terminator 2. In Terminator 2. The SOG Bowie 2.0. Look at that beauty. Look at her. Sarah Connor sitting at like a picnic table playing around with it. If you ever see Terminator 2 again halfway through, you do see her with this guy right here. What a beautiful knife. One of my favorites. We'll treasure this always. Never part with. Never, never, never. Most recent from The Revenant. And this was custom made by Bud Smith, Bud and Miss Tutty. They provided knives and purses and wallets or whatever for the movie The Revenant. Wallets. You can find them online. They will make you one. This was the knife that Leonardo DiCaprio's Hugh Glass carried. The thing that took down the knife that took down the Grizz. And that's my, I do have a certificate of authenticity, but I really love this sheath. Custom made. Love how they did that. And it's pretty darn sharp too. Could I take down a Grizz with this? Nah, I don't think so. And but in real life, Hugh Glass, you know, he did fight that bear. And to be honest with you, no spoiler alert, I say it was a tie. I mean, maybe the bear could have been saved if he had some friends that would help him out, but nah, Hugh Glass was much more important. Anyway, if you haven't seen The Revenant, highly recommend it. Highly recommend it. All right, let's go over here. We're almost done, guys. Dundee, Crocodile Dundee. Come on, who doesn't have a Dundee knife? I did a video on similar knives. This one is by Down Under, the Outback. Love this knife. Oh, boy. My daughter's boyfriend was actually checking these out, and he says, oh, that's my favorite. That's my favorite in your collection. That's the one in your movie knife collection. And then I showed him, I did a video on this also, the Inglorious Bastards. My Aldo Rain special, custom made. I had a guy make this for me out in Washington State. Look at that beauty. Now, it's not the replica that they would sell in stores. They never sold this in stores. So he had the specs and everything, and he did his best, and I think he pretty much nailed it. The Aldo Rain, look at that spine. Look at that. He did such a phenomenal job with this. Can't be happier. Oh, yeah. It's got great weight to it, too. So now, yeah, that was my nephew's favorite then. He said, oh, yeah, it's better than the Dundee. And then I showed him my Serapin Falls. Serapin Falls. First of all, I love that leather sheath it comes with by Mueller. And this is the big boy. As you can see, it's got the medallion on the end. I love those outdoor, you know, survival movies. So, last but not least, he finally left my house saying, that one is my favorite knife. He said he loves the weight of it. He loves the design of the blade. He loves, absolutely loves the medallion. And he said he likes the way that stag, you know, is worn right there. Yes, it was a beauty. It is a beauty. Okay, two more. The movie Predator. Yes, another Arnold Schwarzenegger flick. Predator. I've been wanting this knife for such a long time. A knife / machete. And I finally got it. And it's a beauty. I don't use it. It's just more for show. It's going to be in a nice little case one day. I'm going to put my Predator photos behind it. Along with 90% of these guys. Look at that spine. Yeah, this is a fun blade right here to have, to keep. I know people that have used it. They really don't have any complaints. This one has the Dutch Schaefer autograph and or signature Predator. Now the sheath was crap. It was just a nylon sheath. Well, I took some old camouflage, took some material, and I just redid the sheath to make it look more movie authentic. And I stitched it with some leather stitching right there, and had to use some glue. And I'm very happy, by the way, it came out. I think it turned out rather nicely. Huh? What do you guys think? Let me know. And last but not least, Kill Bill. I got the Hattori Hanzo sword, carried by Uma Thurman's Beatrix, boop boop, Beatrix kiddo. And what we're going to do today when I sign off is we're gonna actually try this. I've never used it. It's got the Ray skin handle. It is a beauty. It's a beauty. I'm gonna set up my phone over here because I have some milk cartons hanging up, as you can see. So let's take a whack at some of these bottles and let's just see how good this is. Take off my jacket. Never used this, so we're gonna give it a whirl. John Bender, 34 years later. There we go. So he gained 70 pounds. What are you gonna do? And the real cool thing is that I do still have my hair. Yes, very real, very real. Not bad for 52. All right, so here we go. Let's see if I can not swing like a girl. We'll start with this guy down here. Guys can see it. Let's see what happens here. All right. That was fun. Oh, I think I hurt my back again. All right, let's try this guy. All right, hardly any effort. Yeah, two for two, people. Alright, what about this one? Alright, let's see. Let's get a little bit here. Took down the whole damn rope. Well, took his head clean off. Look at that. That was fun. All right. Guys, as I always say, let's be careful out there. All right. I hope you enjoyed. And until next time, Alexa, continue. There we go. Don't you forget about me. Like, dislike, but most important, you gotta subscribe. All right? Make sure you subscribe. And we're gonna sign off by, I gotta do one fist pump, right? Yeah, I think we got it over here. Thanks a lot, YouTube. See you soon.